Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris, Brett Summers, Maury Amsterdam, Juliette Mills, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Are you all ready?
Why not? Wait, just a moment.
What?
I do not like that y'all.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It is, are you all ready?
Are you all ready, you all?
That's or right. Is you
baby,
all
baby, I'm going to give you some chitlins in the morning.
Okay. As you can see, they're raring to go. Let's begin the proceedings by welcoming our champion player who's won $950, Marlena Cruz. Hi, Marlena.
Hi, Gene.
How are you?
Oh, fine.
When our time ran out last time, she had just won the $500 in the Big Money Super Match, and that means she's going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. You ready for that?
Yes, I am.
Okay. I'm not ready for you, Marlena. Well, we'll get to her Big Money Super Match right after this message.
Say something to cheer.
It's time for a mix-up. Visit us online today.
Now, we're ready for the big money. Now, you've won the $500. You're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. And to do that, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. And Marlena, it's time to choose one now.
Richard.
You are chosen, Richard.
I always felt I was a cut above the herd.
All right, he'll get ready to write. You face me, if you would, please, Marlena. Here is the $5,000 question. Quarter blank. Quarter blank. Okay, he's finished with his answer, and now it's time for you to give us a response, Marlena. How do you fill in that blank? Quarter?
Quarterback.
Quarterback. Well, I guess that's a reasonable answer in this football season. You like that answer? Okay. What Richard, for $5,000, may we see your response, please?
You had to work him up into a frenzy, right? I said quarter horse.
Quarter horse. See, quarter horse is a horse that can run very fast
for a
quarter of a mile, and then he goes, boom, and that's the end. That's what a quarter horse is. That wasn't a bad answer. Yours wasn't a bad answer either.
I don't even like football.
And you don't even like football, but you said that anyway. Well, Marlena, you're up to $950, as we pointed out, and you're going to meet another player and play another game. So let's welcome that player now. Here comes Barbara Goldberg. Hello, Barbara. You ladies know each other? We welcome you, Barbara, and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself, where you're from and all that.
I live in Sherman Oaks, California. I've got a terrific husband, two young children, a boy and a girl, and I substitute teach whenever they call me, which isn't too often.
Well, I'd call you a lot if I were the principal of the school.
Thank you.
You look like a very smart lady and a good teacher.
Thank you. I hope I do all right now. We'll see.
I hope you do all right here, too. Good luck to both ladies. Let's begin by showing Barbara the question board here. It's up to you to make a selection, Barbara.
I'll take B.
She wants B. This is it, folks. We're underway. As the grand finale to the Hawaiian Festival... King Kamehameha, how do you say that?
Kamehameha.
Oh, don't worry.
Kamehameha.
King Kamehameha.
King Kamehameha always blanks. King Kamehameha always blanks into the great volcano. As the grand finale to the Hawaiian festival, King Kamehameha always blanks into the great volcano. You've been to the festival,
yeah,
have you, Maury?
Many times.
You
yeah.
have.
Well, cooked hot dogs over the fire and everything.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah,
with a lot of laughs.
With a little atapa.
All right. Greg is now ready. And we're waiting for Miss Sloan.
Wait a minute.
What are you doing, Brett?
I just have to clean it up. I mean, not clean it up, but I mean, I have to change it. No, I just have to.
She means edit. She's doing a little editing.
I'll write very quickly, and you'll love it.
Well, I don't know about
there.
That.
Oh, okay.
All right. Now, Barbara.
No.
As the grand finale to the Hawaiian festival, King Kamehameha always blanks into the great volcano.
I don't think he can do it, but I say jumps.
He jumps into the great volcano. All right, that's what she says, and that's her answer. Greg, what do you say?
Well, I'd like to jump after this answer, you see, because I figured he got drunk and he just threw up.
Oh, I see. It's all that sugar in those mixed drinks there.
My ties and all of that.
Brett?
You know what I wish?
What?
I wish Jack Klugman would jump into the great volcano. Well, you know about doo-doo, don't you?
I wish that I did.
Well, this is make... Oh, pardon me, I'm sorry. This is makes Dee-Dee, which is singular.
I see. Okay. All right.
Yeah, I think he drank the same stuff that Greg gave him.
Yes.
He also threw up.
Okay. So, her answer is jumps. And that's what we're looking for, Juliet.
Yeah, well, I'm with the lovely teacher from Sherman Oaks. He jumped in the
volcano. There it is. There's one for you. Finally got a jump here. What do you say, Richard?
Was she ever in the Marines?
He spits into the thing. Jumps is Barbara's answer. Fanny, it's your turn.
I said jumps.
Good girl.
There it is. So you scored twice with that. Now let's see how Marlena does with hers. Everyone plays since it's a first round. Dr. Frankenstein gave his monster a new blank for Christmas. Dr. Frankenstein gave his monster a new blank for Christmas. I find that touching.
Somebody censor Brett before she reads it.
Okay.
That's not bad, Greg.
All right, Marlena. Dr. Frankenstein gave his monster a new...
A new head.
A new head?
Yeah.
For Christmas. Okay. Let's find out if a head comes up here, Greg.
Well, I figured he was a little tired of him, so he gave him a new coffin.
A new coffin. That's where he slept every night.
No.
Brett.
Now you see you all poke fun. And you all make jokes. And you tease me. Head.
Head. There it is. There's one for her. Okay, Maury.
Well...
Whatever that means.
Whatever it is, he wanted a little something of himself, so he gave him a new wind-up toy.
Dumb! Dumb!
I don't ever want to be accused of being dumb on this show again.
Juliet.
Oh, is it my turn?
Yes.
Well, he gave him a new head.
Head! Score is tied at this moment, 2-2. Richard.
Being an old Navy man.
Yep.
New bathroom or head. I see.
That's three heads. Let's see what we have. Better than none, right.
His, hers, and whoever's.
What do you say?
Well, I said that he gave him a new wife for Christmas.
Oh, that was a very kind thought, wasn't it?
She's from
South. So at this moment, at the end of round one, it's 3-2 in favor of the champ. We'll go to round two right after we go to this message for you, friends. Here we go. Round two, ladies, coming up. I push a button and reveal the two questions for Barbara to make a decision.
I'll try B again.
Oh, I don't.
B again. All right. Last time you matched two of our celebrities, Fanny and Juliet, and this time you'll be trying to get the others here. The two of you ladies will not participate. The doctor told dumb Dora she needed some iron in her blood. So Dora ate blank. The doctor told dumb Dora she needed some iron in her blood, so Dora ate blank. In a moment, Barbara.
Nobody on this panel ever said they were quick. Go along.
Okay. Now we're all set? And we'll get a response from Barbara. The doctor told dumb Dora she needed some iron in her blood, so Dora ate...
Magnets?
Magnets?
Magnets.
Iron magnets.
I thought...
Is that what you're saying?
Well, magnets.
Oh, I know. Oh, okay, yeah. I goofed. Okay.
I don't know if you goofed or not. I don't know. Some of the...
Things pick up on.
Some dingbat may say magnets up here. You never know, Barbara.
I take offense.
You do?
Gene,
I think you're very offensive.
Why do you turn on your panel?
Come on now, let me see your answer there, Greg.
She got a strange appetite. She eats rusted pipes.
Rusted pipes.
That's good.
Get a lot of iron in your blood that way. What do you say, Brett?
We all know that fine old ship, Old Ironsides.
Old Ironsides. Okay.
You magnets. Can always use a few nails, even
nails?
If you have to bite them off your own fingers.
Oh. Now, Barbara, you've got to match. You've got to match Richard to stay in the game. What do you say, Richard?
Well, I say, unless I can write another card very hurriedly. Nuts and
nuts
bolts.
And bolts, so Marlena wins again. You won again.
This is really terrific.
I say it's terrific, too. Okay, so there's another $100 for you. And as for you, my dear, aren't you lucky you're leaving just in the nick of time? She's about to have a nervous breakdown. Goodbye, Barbara Goldberg, a gift for you backstage. Here it is. Big money super match for you now, Marlena. You've had three. You've had two goes at this. This is your third. And if you're ready, we'll begin, shall we?
Yes.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank doctor. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Second, $250. And the third, $100. Which ones would you like a little help from?
Maury.
Maury, she'd like a little assist from you. How do you fill in that blank? Blank doctor. Or blank horse. Doctor. Horse doctor, he says.
Greg?
Greg, what do you say to that?
Medical.
Medical doctor. Okay, one more.
Juliet?
Ship's doctor.
Ship's doctor. Okay.
Oh, look at the English always showing off that they travel a lot.
Shut up, Brett.
Medical doctor, horse doctor, and ship's doctor are the three given you by the celebrities. Now, you may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What do you think about this?
Oh, that's a good one.
Somebody in the audience said, how about witch doctor? And Marlena doctor. Thinks that may be a good answer.
I'd hang in with them, honey, if I were you.
Huh?
Go for that. Go for
witch
that.
Doctor.
Right. You want to say witch doctor?
Yes, I hope so. Okay, what do I have? Well, I have a lot to lose, but let's try it.
You think it's witch doctor?
Yeah, I hope so.
All right.
Even 100 would be good.
That's right. Anything would be better than nothing, wouldn't it? Okay. Which you can't be greedy, right? Which doctor is the one she's looking for? Let's find out if it's up there. Here is the $100 response. Medical doctor is up there for the one that Greg gave you. Okay. You almost said that one?
I almost went with that one.
Yeah, well, still got two more chances. Here we go. Here is the $250 response. Horse doctor.
Oh, my God. What if it's witch doctor?
Oh, boy. What if it's witch doctor? Okay. Hold on now.
Okay.
Here we go. Ready? She's looking for witch doctor. Here's the $500 response. Okay. All right.
I enjoyed that. That was very nice. You coming by this way again? Something nice.
They saved you, didn't they?
And I don't even know them. And look how nice mine is.
Gene, can I ask Marlena something?
Look at them.
They're the ones that said witch doctor. Okay. Before
May
we go
I
on,
ask a question?
Richard has a question. What was your question?
Were you ever known as Chatty Cathy?
Ask a question.
Here we go. Now, Marlena, you've won the $500. It means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Which one will it be?
Maury.
Maury Amsterdam. All right, Maury, get ready to write. Here we go. You face me, if you would, please, Marlena. Here's the $5,000 question, Maury. United blank. United blank. Put your card in the slot there if you're finished, Maury. He is finished. How do you fill in the blank? United
States.
United States, Maury.
Also chipped in a shoe for you there. Good luck.
They make you a little taller?
Yeah.
Well, you can buy 10-foot heels if you want. You know how much money you got? You got $6,000. Okay.
It's the show you.
Now we're ready.
Donate now.
Now we're ready to start another game. Marlena has pulled herself together, and she's ready to take on a new challenger. So let's welcome Brenda Lee Merriweather. Hi, Brenda Lee.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi, thank you.
Want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, I'm a student. I attend Cal State University, Long Beach, and I'm studying finance.
Finance?
Yes.
Well, she could use a financial advisor here to tell her what to do with her $6,550. Oh, or do you know what to do with it?
Oh, I know what to do with it.
Okay. Well, good luck to you, Brenda Lee. I'll push the button and show you two questions here and ask you the challenger to make a selection.
B.
B is for Brenda, and this is what she gets.
B is also for booze.
Barbara said to the interior decorator, "Why, Mr. Sidney, what are you doing in my blank?" Barbara said to the interior decorator, "Hi, Mr. Sidney, what are you doing in my blank?" Finished.
Yes.
Happy.
Yes.
All right, upper tier is ready, Fanny. We're waiting for you. Okay, Brenda Lee, Barbara said to the interior decorator, "Why, Mr. Sidney, what are you doing in my blank?"
Bed.
In my bed. Okay, audience seems to think that's a good answer. Greg, what do you think of it?
Well, it's really the same location. I said boudoir.
Boudoir. Same location, but no match. No, no, wait, she said bed. She said bed. And,
well, the bed is in the boudoir. Where is it, in the kitchen, in the sink?
No.
Sometimes, honey, it's all fun to where you are.
No, I don't live in the Klugman house.
Oh, that's true. I'd forgotten that. But you've been hanging around lately. Yes, dear.
Show and tell time.
Tell the truth. Is Barbara smoking gasoline?
No.
You sure?
No.
Okay, I said bed.
Bed it is. There you go. There's one. Okay, Maury. What do you got there?
I happen to know this decorator.
One of
what are you doing in my negligee?
Maury, you sit there, you look like you're sound asleep, and you come up with an answer like that. Holy mackerel.
That's all when right. You think of those kind of things when you're sound asleep.
Okay. Tell us, Julia.
Yeah, well, I know that decorator of Maury's. I wouldn't want him in my bed. I said, in my closet.
He was hiding in a closet. Right. He was a closet decorator.
The closet,
okay.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
What are you doing in my negligee?
Yes.
He said the foxtrot.
No, I said dress. That's what my interior is.
Dress, yes.
And okay. It looks very nice in it, too. I take him dancing. Time just flies away.
You know, that's not fair to interior decorators. I said, what are you doing in my house?
In my house.
Yeah, okay. See, that's a clever answer, so, Fanny.
And we'll come to you, but first we've got to do a little business here, and this is it.
This. Go to GoodRx.com to see if you can save on your prescriptions.
Okay, ladies, our time is just about up. We've got to stop here in the middle of round one, but we'll pick up at that point when we meet again, okay?
All right.
All right.
Okay.
Okay. Count your money. Listen, we didn't get a chance to get any details from you, Greg, on this program you're developing. Can you tell us anything about it? Or?
Yeah, very briefly, we hope to be able to use the credentials and the files, et cetera, of the Drug Enforcement Administration. I have been in anti-drug abuse for a long time, and now I would like to do a series about it.
So it'll be an entertainment thing, but performing a public service at the same time.
Yeah, it will be primarily entertainment, and he will be all over Kansas City, California, all over the world.
Would you shoot it everywhere?
Everywhere we can, yes.
Gee, that's terrific. I want to get on that show.
Notice him. He's a junkie.
Not true.
Yes, I am.
Yeah. Oh, you are?
I'm a kid junkie.
Yeah.
A kid junkie?
Yeah, because I think the kids of today are the greatest group of people I've ever met in my life.
Hear, hear.
Yeah.
Hear, hear.
I think that's terrific,
and we wish you well with it.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure. I don't think the kids today are any worse than they were 25 years ago. They just have better weapons.
Right. Okay, thank you all. You were splendid. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are from Dan Rivers. Sheets and pillowcases in many different patterns and prints of Fortrell polyester and cotton. Sheets and pillowcases to dream on from Dan Rivers. And chicken of the sea tuna, hand filleted, so you get only prime fillet tuna. The choice is cut delicately seasoned and baked twice. Chicken of the sea. And a supply of Johnson's Future, the acrylic floor finish. It gives you a tough acrylic shine that holds up. Future, beautifully transparent, tougher than wax. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.